Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he taught his companions how to pray, at the end of this hadith, he said, he taught them how to conclude the prayer. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, once you finish at-tahiyyat, you're completed, you finished, then select and choose what you like of a dua and ask Allah azza wa jal. And this is an incredible time to make dua, because it's at the end of the prayer, just before you say assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. Wallahi, my brothers and sisters in Islam, do you understand how precious this time is and how important this time is? Let me tell you how important it is. So you've made wudu, you've faced the qibla, you've said Allahu Akbar, declaring Allah's greatness. You stood facing Allah in your prayer. You've recited Al-Quran, the word of Allah. You've made ruku' and glorified Allah in your ruku'. Then you got up and you said, Sami' Allahu liman hamidah, Rabbana walakal hamd, and you've began to praise Allah. And then you made sujood and you glorified Allah. You humbled yourself before Allah. And then you repeated this rak'ah two times or three or four times. And then you finally sat for at-tashahhud, which is a humble, submissive, obedient type of sitting. And after all this, you said, At-tahiyyatu lillah, was-salawatu at-tayyibat. You said, greetings and prayers and all the good things belong to Allah. And then you made salat ala al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then you said the shahada, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. After all this, now you are in an excellent position to make dua. Don't leave a salat until you make a dua. You understand why this time was important and precious? Because it comes after doing all this for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. This is why never conclude your salat except after making dua. And there is dua that is mentioned from the sunnah, like Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min azab al-nar wa min azab al-qabr wa min fitnat al-mahya wal-mamat wa min fitnat al-masih al-dajjal. This dua is going to save you from the punishment of the grave, and it's going to save you from the fire, and it is going to save you from every fitna in this life and during death, and it's going to save you from the biggest fitna, which is fitnat al-dajjal. Make this dua before you make assalamu alaykum, before you do at-tasleem.